This Guru Ashtakam, as it, the very title says, Guru Ashtakam. Ashtakam is, Ashtam means how much?
Eight.
Good. So eight verses on the Guru. Again, we have seen Guru Stotram, we have seen Guru Padaka Stotram. In the Guru Stotram, it is the glory of the Guru. In the Guru Padaka Stotram, it is glory of the Padakas. Here, the composer, which probably not Shankaracharya, it is not known, we'll find out. It is written Padaka, let's see. It's not Shankaracharya, somebody else, otherwise he would have mentioned here. And this is about, if you don't have a guru in your life, what use is anything else? This is the main theme of this eight verses. Because in the Hindu tradition, the knowledge cannot be, is not possible without the proper preceptor. Therefore, in the typical Hindu tradition, every family will have a family deity and family guru. Kula guru they call. Why it is important? Because for situations about law, you can go to a lawyer. Situations with respect to your health and physical and well-being, you can go to a doctor. If you want any furniture to be done, you can go to the carpenter. So all of them have a specific person to take care. But when it comes to spiritual dilemmas or dharma dilemmas, whom do you go? What is right and what is not right? Whom do we go and ask? Google? So doing right and wrong today, we are not even bothered because whatever we think and we do is right. We never ask anybody. Do we? Am I doing the right thing? Am I treating the situation rightly or according to my whims and fancies? What I am doing in my life, is it appropriate? Is it useful? We evaluate the usefulness of any action in terms of how much it gains to us. Money, name, fame, whatever. So in the past, the kings had the Kula Guru. They prominently present in the Sabha. And any decision that Guru, any decision the king takes, not only the ministers are consulted, but the Guru also is consulted. So accordingly they guide, okay, this is Dharma, this is not Dharma. Whether the king will follow or not, that is up to him. But the teachers were always there, like we have seen in Ramayana, Vasishtha was there, Vishwamitra was there. In the case of Janaka, again, there are many other gurus, including Vasishtha, including Vishwamitra. In Mahabharata, we see Dronacharya was there. Of course, he was only an archer. But Bhishma Pitama himself was a great knower of Dharma. He was there. So, we do see that family preceptor or Kula Guru are playing a very important role in decision making. So here this set of verses says, if you have all the various facilities, comforts and luxuries and wealth and everything is there, but if your mind is not able to find its abode in the thought of Guru, what use is that? So one Sanskrit word you will learn today is tatakim. Two letters, two words. So what? It's nice to learn that particular statement because if somebody says something, tatakim. So what? Tatakim. So what? Of what use? That's what it means. So what? Well, you may have all these things, but if you don't have the Guru, so what? See, if you are learning music, let us say, when you are on the stage, to whom you should prostrate first is your guru, even before Bhagavan. Number one. Number two is, if you are not doing well or if you are doing well also, they will first ask, who is your teacher? Is it not true? If that if it does well also, we'll find out what kind of a student he has got. And such a nice, who is your teacher? I want to appreciate that person first. And if you are not doing well, who is your teacher? So teacher gets credit or blame according to the performance of the student. So the teacher plays an important role in making the individual who he is or who she is. So here, the composer here saying, you may have so many different luxuries and other things in your life. So many things you might have accomplished. So what? Shariram surupam yatava kalatram. Yashascharu chitram danam meru tulyam.
Yashascharu chitram danam meru tulyam.
Manasche nalagnam harerangri padme.
Manasche nalagnam harerangri padme.
Tatakim 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 tatakim. Shariram surupam yatava kalatram yashascharu chitram danam merutulyam manasye nalagnam harerangri padme tadakim 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 tadakim. Last line definitely you will remember. Tadakim tadakim tadakim. Kim tadak? Tada, I mean thereafter what? So what? So here there are patandra. Patandra means the difference in verse, the versions. Hare Rangri Padme is there in the third line. You see, sometimes they put in the first line, in the first verse itself, Guru Rangri Padme. Like all other verses you will see, it's all Guru Rangri Padme. Guroho of the Guru, Angri Pada. Pada Padme, in the lotus feet of the teacher, Manaha Lagnam Nachet. Manaha, mind, Lagnam, merge. Lagona, Lagna, okay. Hindi may be either. Usko Laga. Laga means put it there, right? Keep it there. So if the mind is not kept, Lagnam is to merge or to keep there. If the mind is not kept, nachet, nachet means if it is not. Chet means if, nachet means if not. Manaha chet na lagnam. Manaha lagnam nachet. If the mind is not kept, where? Harehe angri padme. Hara. Hara means Bhagavan Shiva. Hari is Bhagavan Vishnu. Harehe. Harehe angri, in the feet of Lord Vishnu, Hariya. But another version is Guroho, as I said. So, Hare Rangri Padme Manaste Na Lagnam, if your mind is not put at the feet of the Lord. So what, so what, so what, so what. You can write in English. And there was one Keshav Das, you know, might have heard him. Keshav Das is from Bangalore. He was Dasa Parampara. He converted all these things to English. And he used to sing. And a lot of local people, Americans used to come and you will talk like that. Good body and beauty, you have good wife. You have a great fame and a beautiful ornaments. The wealth is comparable to Himalayan mountain. If the mind is not there at the feet of the Lord, so what, so what, so what? It'll be nice if you put
the beauty.
No, it's not like that. You can do that. Why not? I mean, you have to tune it properly.
Does he have MP3s of those?
Huh?
Does he have MP3s of those?
We we can make it. What is it? You know, like last time when Gita, our camp for the children, I made the song on Krishna. You know about that. I made a whole Bhagavad Gita. For Bhagavad Gita, I made a song on Jingle Bells. What is that song? I don't know. I just came up on the day we started the camp. Anyway, I may remember that. So the whole song on Krishna's Gita, Bhagavad Gita, based upon jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. So, can make it. So here what he says, if your mind is not able to be kept at the feet of the Lord, what? All these things, what news? Shariram surupam, surupam shariram, surupam, su when you add good, rupam form. Your body is full of beauty. You are very good looking. Yata, and also, va kalatram. Yata surupam, shariram surupam, kalatram va. Even though beautiful, it surupam goes with kalatra also. Kalatra is wife. Your body is beautiful, your wife is beautiful. Yashaha, fame. Charuchitram, beautiful ornaments. Dhanam, wealth. Meru tulyam. Tulyam means equal to. Meru, like that of a Meru mountain, which is considered to be the mystical mountain, which is the tallest in the world. Tallest is the center of the universe, it is said. Meru is the center of the universe. You know that the chakra, when you make the Sri Chakra and all those things, the middle point is Meru. So it is the highest point, it's a mystical, spiritual mountain. So your wealth may be equal to that of the Meru mountain. Even then, if your mind is not put at the feet of the Lord, so what? You know, I want to make one t-shirt, so what? So anybody says any problem, show it, so what?
So you make both front and back.
The front must be so what? Back is don't beat me. Because if I ask so what, you will say what?
Manasche nalagnam gururangri padme tatakim 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 tatakim.
You know, this is really a very interesting thing. You know, when problems come in our life, we do not know. People ask this question. How do we let go, Swamiji? Ask the question. So what? So many things have happened in our life, good or bad. Oh, what an amount of impact that has got now. Only regrets, only in the form of memories. Good things also, bad things also. So if you are able to let go, so what? I mean, we go on holding it, we keep on hovering around it and keep on brooding over it, then it becomes too much to handle. So you have put a so big this thing in your, what do you call, it's just above your computer. So what? Once in a while you should look at it. So what? Yeah, everything happens, goes on and on and on. He unnecessarily put too much of our head into that. Because nobody practices around us, therefore we don't even know the effect of it. If somebody is able to constantly, you know, tell us, so what? So it will be easy for us to let go. But see, it's like your own dream. As soon as you wake up, you probably remember it so intensely because it has just happened. After some time, so on. There is no relevance to what I am doing right now. Somebody may think that, okay, whatever I dreamt early, so somebody, early morning dream comes true. You stupid idea, you know, I'm telling you. Unnecessarily, they go on brooding. I thought like this. So what? Oh, he didn't invite me for his marriage. So what? Better, you don't ever need to go for gifts or anything. Money saved. What's the big deal? It's better that, you know, you just let go of all these things. So,
మనశ్చేన్న లగ్నం గురోరం హరేరంగ్రి పద్మే తతక్యం 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 తతక్యం. You know, that is the reason why, you know, the example of lotus leaf on a water, you know, it is always always given that. Even that Odissi dancer, you know, showed that. It doesn't draw drop of water, it is there in the water but untouched. Padma Patram Ivam Basa, Shankara, I mean, Bhagavan Krishna also says. Karma Yogi should work in this world like that of lotus leaf on the water, on the pond. It's just there but not touched. The quoting that is given is, you know, the other day, you know, that I told you, I was with Yokendra people in Chicago. I was telling them that how working in this world, the detachment is like putting oil in your hand when you are opening the jackfruit. Jackfruit is very sticky substance is there. When you put oil and then open it, then you can remove the fruits easily. And after that you can just wash it. If you don't, at least next to 10 days you will be doing this because it's so sticky. So one should work in this world like that. So one by raised his hand. Yes. When should I put the oil? Where are you taking it literally? What I mean is, keep your mind like that and detach, that's what I mean. It's not physically putting some oil.
Kalatram danam putra pautradi sarvam.
Griham
bandava sarvamedat. Hi jatam.
Griham bandhava sarvametatvi jatam.
Manasche nalagnam gurorangri padme.
Manasche nalagnam gurorangri padme.
Tatakim 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 tatakim.
Tatakim tatakim tatakim.
Kalatram danam putra pautradi sarvam griham bandava sarvamedati jatam manasye nalagram gurorangri padme tatakim 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 tatakim. Kalatram wife, danam wealth, putra son, pautra grandson, Adi sarvam, all these. Griham, house, bandavaha, relatives, sarvam, all these. Edathi sarvam, let there be. I'm not saying you should not have that. Let it be. Edathi jatam. Jatam edathi, let them be there. Let it be. Even then. Manasche nalagnam gurorangri patme. If your mind is not at the feet of the lotus feet of the teacher, tatakim, tatakim. So what is all these things? You know, Nachiketa was given so many things, but did he ever, you know, he said, you are giving all these things. What use is that? You are giving long life, putra, pautra, popautra. He says, great grandson also. All the wealth, all the things. He says, All these things are Shashvan Nashwarameva Vishwamakilam. It is a constant change and death. Now what use is that? Your Gurudev used to say, keep your dance and damsels with you. I don't need it. Sarvendriyanam Jarayanti Tejaha. All these are going to only exhaust you. Taveva Vaha Tamarutya Gite. Keep the dance and damsels with you. I don't want. So here he says, if there will be. Because the guru's role is not the individual ego, it is the teaching to the soul. He doesn't teach to the mind. Because whatever we learn in this life, next life we don't remember it. Whatever we have learned as an intellectual understanding or with the mind what we have learned, so what you have learned, so many things in your school, do you remember all of that?
How many years you went to school? Tell me. 20 years? School means including university. 20 years, every day. So out of 360 days, let us say 300 days, or maybe 200 days you went. 5 to 6 hours? Every day? Okay. Now calculate. 200 days per year. 20 years, 400, you know, how much?
No, 1,000 per year.
Huh?
1,000 hours per year.
1,000 hours per year. Let us say 1,000 hours per year. 20 years. 20,000 years. 20,000 hours. What did you learn? 20,000 hours. What did you learn? You remember? So, what we have learned through our mind doesn't stay. It, maybe you, when you practice and use it for some time, and yes, it will be useful for some lifetime. That's it. And unfortunately, you can't carry the knowledge next life. So, the spiritual teachings are not like that. Otherwise, nobody will go for it. Bahunam janmanamante jnanavanmam prabhatyade. Vasudeva sarvamiti. Bhagavan Krishna says, after many lives one will come to know this. Meaning, once you learn, you are moving forward. In 6th chapter also, Arjuna asked this question, what happens if a person is not able to reach that state of perfection and dies in between? He says, nothing is wasted. Nahi kalyanakrit kaschati durgadim tadagacchati. A person who has gone, started walking in this path will not go back. I will not allow this. Durgadim na gacchati. He will not go to the wrong path. So that means what? Life after life, as the soul starts learning the spiritual knowledge, it moves forward. And it is not just an intellectual knowledge. If it is only intellectual knowledge, it will be as good as anything else. Next birth again, you start from the scratch. That is not the way. So he says, even as the person dies without reaching that perfection, he will either go and be born as a son of a yogi, or he will be born to a rich person where he need not worry about his basic needs of life. He will start from the day he is born, that day he will begin his spiritual journey from then onwards. A guru, a true guru is one who will exactly note which amount of degree the soul has developed. From there you will pick up. It's like when you draw a painting or something and halfway because it's night you went to sleep and next day when you start from there only. Some people cook previous night itself and then half cooked or keep it and the next day morning they'll continue. Or you are putting, what do you call that? Dough, you know. You put it for the night and then next day you begin. In the same way, this knowledge transcends death and life. Life and death. Otherwise this teaching will be another intellectual process only. And many scholars who only intellectualize, they don't gain anything. Why? Because they intellectualized, next birth they have to start again. So that is the basic difference between Western and Eastern philosophy. Western philosophy only has an outlook about life in the world. But whereas Eastern one is like beyond this world. Because they believe in continuation, perpetuation of the soul across lives. This is not in the Western tradition. So the soul, this teacher does not teach the student, he teaches to the soul, to the person beyond their physical body. So if you have many comforts and luxuries and joy and other name, fame in this life, kalatram danam putra pautra adi sarvam griham bandhava sarvame dati jata. All of them are the same kind. Guru Rangri Patme Manaschena Lagnam or Manaschena Lagram Guru Rangri Patme Tatakim Tatakim Tatakim. So what? So what? So what?
Shadangadi Vedo Mukhe Shastra Vidya. Kavitvadi Gadyam Supatyam Karoti.
Kavitvadi Gadyam Supatyam Karoti.
Manasye Nalagnam Gurorangri Padme.
Manasye Nalagnam Gurorangri Padme.
Tatakim, 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 Tatakim. Shadangadi Vedo Mukhe Shastra Vidya Kavitvadi Gadyam Supatyam Karoti Manasye Nalagnam Gurorangri Padme Tadakim 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 Tadakim.
Even if you are a well-read scholar, Shad Anga Adi Mukhe Shastra Vidya Vedahascha. Mukhe, in your mouth, Shastra Vidya, all these Shastraic knowledge, and you know the six limbs of Vedas. The six limbs of Vedas being, there are six Upavedas are there for understanding Vedas. Shiksha, Kalpa, Vyakarana, Niruktam, Chandasam, Jyotisham. Phonetic, I explained, I think, sometime. Phonetics, the way to pronounce the letters. Phonetics, that is Shiksha. Vyakarana, grammar. Chandas, meter. The poetic meters, one understands how it is formed. Niruktam, etymology. Kalpa, the science of rituals. And Jyotisham is astrology. So, phonetics, grammar, meter, then etymology, science of rituals, as well as astrology. These are necessary to understand what is said in the Vedas. So, one knows all this. Shadanga, Diveda, Mukhe Shastra Vidya, all the Shastras, all the ritualistic various injunctions and how to do, what mantra to chant, everything he has. Shastra Vidya Mukhe. And Kavitvadi Gadyam, one is best among all the poets. Kavitva means poetic excellence, a skill. Supadyam, a lasting impressions one has created, karoti. Supadyam, a lasting impression, a footprint you have created in the world of poetry. So what? Manasche nalagnam gurorangri padme. You know, it is the greatest sin in a person can do is learn but never be gratitude to his teacher. That's the greatest sin. You learn from someone and you don't even acknowledge that he is my teacher is the greatest sin. Unfortunately, many people are like that. Even the so-called roadside Romeos nowadays, who are claiming themselves to be the new age gurus, they don't even acknowledge that whom they have learned from. Many people even take the message from Upanishad but even don't even say that it is from the Upanishad. This is what's called new wave philosophers. It's from Gita, it is from Upanishad. The rishis have contemplated and gave this knowledge to us, we don't even acknowledge. My own thinking. What do you mean by that?
That's the ego, right?
Ego, not only that, because by saying so, they would think that I'm original. Meaning I am a guru on my own. Anyway, the point is,
it's only for name and fame.
Yeah, that's what he says. If you don't have your mind in the guru, Of all these things, of what use is this? All you may have. You may have all the Shastra Vidya. You may have all the various knowledge. See, even as Ekalaiva. Ekalaiva was one who has learnt archery, not even with the physical guru. But his Guru Dakshina was ready to give up his very even the finger without which he cannot even do it. He was so satisfied with the knowledge, he doesn't want any name and fame. That's why he is kept in a high, even greater than Dronacharya. Why? Because Dronacharya was partial towards Arjuna, and here is the one who said, okay, I don't want to even practice this anymore, but I am so happy that I gained the knowledge from you. He had only one love, that's called Ekalav. Ekalavya means one who had only one love for the knowledge. He is ready to give up his thumb. So, Manas,
was it an appropriate act?
That is not, we are not to justify that. Dronacharya, what he did, why did it, we are not here to justify. Because he wanted to make sure that there is nobody can beat Drona, I mean Arjuna. That was his point. Because he was dead against Drupada. I'm not going to the Mahabharata story now. He wanted to defeat Drupada, but unfortunately, when Arjuna married Drupada's daughter, he got so unhappy about it. Because the enemy for which he prepared him, he became his son-in-law. That's why he went to the other side to support Duryodhana. So, anyway, the dedication and the gratitude with which one should learn this knowledge. Even if you have the great, knowledge about the science of rituals and etymology and all other six Upavedas, but even then, even if you are a great poet and lasting impressions you have created in this world, manasche nalagnam guru rangripatne tatakim 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 tatakim. Videsheshu manyah swadesheshu danyah.
Videsheshu manyah swadesheshu danyah.
Sadachara vritteshu matto na chanyah.
Sadachara vritteshu matto na chanyah.
Manasche nalagnam gurorangri padme. Tatakim, 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 tatakim.
Tatakim, 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 tatakim.
Videsheshu manyah swadesheshu danyah. Tadachara vritteshu matto na chanyah. Manasche na lagnam gurorangri padme tatakim 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 tatakim. You are honored in foreign lands. Videsha. Videsha means Vigata Desha or Viruddha Desha, a different country, not one's own. Vivida Desheshu, Videsheshu, Manyaha. You have become very honored. Swadesheshu, in your own home, your own country, danya, you are blessed. You are very well respected. And sadhachara, in your conduct, in your behavior, vritta, vritteshu, in your conduct and character, mattaha, anyaha, nacha. There is nobody greater than me. Nobody is more noble, more well-known by character and behavior. There is nobody compared to oneself. Even then, manaste nalagnam guru rangri patmi. Some people ask me this question. Swamiji, if a person is a good person, one who has right values, helping others and doing his work, and in general a nice person, good person, is it not sufficient? No.
Have that half towards his guru anyway.
If there is no guru, that's what his question is.
But
The point is, if a person is good in all respects, but does not have a guru to initiate him, direct him to spiritual goal, he may have all other worldly responsibilities doing, he's fulfilling everything all right. Good person, have right values in place, helping each others, everything is fine. Good person. But does not have the spiritual goal in his life. There is no spiritual guidance. So that person will remain good, no doubt, but does not move to the enlightened state. And it is not that our mind, we know our mind. Is it the same all the time? So long as the physical body is healthy, everything looks good. Once the physical body starts becoming, withering away, straining away, etc., what one can do is no more able to do it. Earlier one is able to help many people and now one cannot do it. So, obviously the mind will say, if I have helped so many people, now why nobody is helping me? There is a possibility the mind will start becoming cynical, critical, expecting and getting disappointed. So, unless a person has the unifying spiritual goal of seeing one truth in everything and everyone, there is even the goodness does not become a greatness. Our Guruji used to say, Swami Tejami, goodness to greatness is only when there is a spiritual goal. That goodness does not have itself any. Vibhishna was a good person. Right? He was sitting in the Rakshasastra. Meaning he was sitting there. Until he met the Bhagavan with the help of Hanumanji, basically. Hanuman himself was a good person. Until when he was serving Sugriva, he was a good minister. But when he met Bhagavan, or when he had come in contact with the Lord, the whole thing changed. The purpose of life has changed. So also many people, you see, not bad people, they were good people. But then goodness remains goodness, does not become greatness. So, videsheshu manyaha, you may honored in many, many places, or you are whatever knowledge you have got. So, videsheshu danyaha. Sadachara vrittyeshu, one's own conduct and behavior, matto nacha anyaha. There is nobody comparable to such a person. Mattaha than me, anyaha, another, na. Nobody other than me, meaning who is as noble as oneself. Manaha guroho angripatme na lagnam chet. If the mind is not at the feet of the teacher, see, even the most, well-known, accomplished individual, as far as the guru is concerned, he does not look at how much money a person has got, how much name and fame another person has got, how much, that person is known to the world. In front of him, everybody is the same. If he is a person who values money and name, fame of the person, and looks down another person based upon the money, name and fame, the gurutva is not there in him. He cannot evaluate, judge the people based upon how well they are known to the world. As far as the guru is concerned, the development of the soul, the purity and the purity and immaculate nature of the soul is necessary, and devotion of the soul is necessary, then what he has got in his physical world. Do you evaluate a person's greatness according to his dream? You had a good dream, you must be a good person. Now what do you mean by that? In the same way, from guru's standpoint, whatever you have got is in the relative world. It has no relevance to your soul. It is in this physical body you are blessed with money and wealth and whatnot. Another person is not. But from the standpoint of the higher nature, that has no meaning. There's no relevance. So,
One may not say that, okay, a person who is of such great knowledge and accomplishment, he goes to the guru, guru will treat him differently. Definitely not. Because they are of the samadrishti. They have the same view of everybody. That's what Krishna also says in chapter 6 very nicely, that a person may be a very well vidya vinaya sampanne brahmane gavi hastini shunichaiva shvabake cha pandita samadarshina. Men of knowledge, right vision is men of equal vision. They do not compare one with another. Each one is an individual. Each one is undertaking individual journey. How can I help the individual to come out of his own confusion? Kshama mandale bhupa bhupala vrindaihi.
Kshama mandale bhupa bhupala vrindaihi.
Sada sevitam yasya padaravindam.
Sada sevitam yasya padaravindam.
Manaschena lagnam gurorangri padme. Tatakim, 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 tatakim.
Tatakim, 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 tatakim.
Kshama mandale bhupa bhupala vrindai. Tata sevitam yasya padaravindam. Manasyena lagnam gurorangri padme. Tatakim, 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 tatakim. Shama means earth, because patience, shama is, shama mandala means bhumandala, because this earth is known for its patience and tolerance. We jump and then we, you know, huge buildings are built and what not, and then even nuclear bombs are bombed. Okay. You will get the result of all these things by yourself and need not do anything. So this is called Shama Mandala. Bhupa Bhupala Vrintaihi. And even if it is the very lean, a host of many, 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 many different kings of the world, Sada Sevidam Yasya Padaravindam. Even if you are being, whose feet are being worshipped by many, many kings and great people in this world, if that person's mind is not in the feet of the teacher, no use. One may be the most wealthiest, most wanted person in this world, most worshipped, glorified, adored. Even if you are, your house is full of people constantly waiting to look at you or have a word with you. You may be so many different kings and rulers of the country are all ready to be at your feet. Even then, if your mind is not at the feet of the teacher. Because then what results is ego and arrogance and pride and haughtiness and power and authority. In this country, people believe in authority, not in nobility. TSA, you know, standing there with a badge and then a gun. You are afraid of that person. Everywhere you see, people are afraid of authority, law, and whatnot. Is it not? Because that is the way the society is built. Authoritative person rules. So a person of authority, person of money, person of power is more important than anybody who has knowledge, nobility. That is why even when Mahatma Gandhi walked with a very single cloth and then he just walked into the parliament of, in British parliament. What was the statement made by Churchill? Who is this half-naked fakir? And he has to come and talk to us? We are the rulers.
But Gandhiji hardly cared for such statements. Because in a land where knowledge and wisdom are worshipped, authority has no way can overrule them. Where there is authority and power and position and money is the ruling power, there religion will not survive that much. On the other hand, the people only believe in religion also, this is another problem. So there should be state and religion, they should have a concrete balance. Neither state should be ruling all the time, nor the religion should be ruling all the time. There should be a clear demarcation of where they have their own role to play. And then even people of knowledge, people of spirituality, they don't look them down upon as useless people. People, places like China, etc. What religion cannot survive there. So even the king should have the right kind of appreciation, respect, reverence to that knowledge. And that is being taught in the Rajadharma in India. Rajadharma is you must have proper reverence and dedication and acceptance and respect for the religious beliefs also. Otherwise, you know, the majority of the people have faith in religion in any country than money and power. Inherently there is faith. But that part of it one should not overlook at all. So it should be taught to the children as well. You may have power, position, money, you may learn well, you may study well, you may achieve many things, but that aspect of your personality which should be equally accepted, equally should be given respect, should not be overlooked at all. Because someone who does not develop that part of the personality will eventually collapse. Because this side of the personality doesn't stay always the same. Economy will be down, and whatever you learn becomes useless after some time. Then, Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramayah, Sarve Bhadrani Pasyantu, Makasya Dukkha Bhavet, Om Shanti Shanti Shanti, Hari Om Sri Guru.